Well, thank you for the question. And in some way, I get the impression that you're just walking two different legs. And maybe for the audience, the working title of this conference was The Age of Stupidity, and I ended up on a conference named School of Civilization. So there we see a more optimistic approach. And we heard also on this table that it is life is full of paradoxes. And you also wrote it in your essay. You quoted Dickens saying, we are living in the worst of times and we're living in the best of times. And I'm of the school that I think, well, if there are two options available, I would like to choose in the best of times and use it to decrease the size of the worst of times. And I think that the world of arts and music really has a crossroads with education. And that is that it's all about the development of the inner self and the exploration of time, space, beauty, that you can connect to your surrounding. And it was a beautiful example. When you live in the woods with a wolf, you will never become a human being. And I think both schools and the world of art give you the opportunity to connect with the space around you, to know your place, to know what kind of times you're living in, and to what times we connect by playing Bach or by playing Mozart. You can learn something about European culture. And I think that especially beauty and the morality of beauty is something that is so important for my generation. We're living in a more secular time. We're living in a time where we all have education, have relatively good incomes. But we do not really have something more than this really flat, amoral way of life. And I think that beauty can really play a big role in it to develop people to more interesting and nice people. And for myself, for instance, that's the world of Mahler. I grew up in a very Catholic family. I lost God when I was 12 or something. There was nothing anymore, so I really had a quite rude period in my puberty. And then I developed got back to the world of music because my parents played a lot of music, and realized there's something between this sometimes ugly, sometimes not so very nice, as Johann Sims called the hell, and between the heaven that doesn't exist. So, and that's the world of arts and of music. So yeah, it is relevant. At the same time, is it relevant to talk about it? Sometimes I have the feeling that we tend to talk and write and discuss too much about the topic instead of experience the topic itself. So you were asking how many of your members of the Concertgebouw are here in this concert hall. And then I said to you, well, it's more important to experience the primary sources. So I rather have that you listen for the first time to Bach or to Mozart or to Mendelssohn, and after that, talk about it. Because in our society, it's so much also in our education about knowledge and about a rational worldview that people don't dare to even experience music because they tend to think that they don't know anything about it. And I think you first should experience it and listen for it like for 10 times, and after it, you can say something about it. As a little anecdote, for instance, the corporate sponsor of the orchestra in this concert hall once had a meeting, and they flew over all kind of managers and all kind of other boring people. And it literally cost, well, just thousands and thousands of euros. And then more than half of it didn't turn up because they were just afraid, and especially the young people. They were afraid that the colleague would say, well, wasn't it this nice? And did you hear this little musical trick or trope? And they were just afraid and ashamed that they couldn't talk about it. So sometimes I think maybe we should just not talk about it, but experience it, listen to it, open your heart to it. And the talk will come later if you go on with it and develop yourself in this musical world. So yeah, of course, read this book, read this topic, but for the most, it's a driver for enthusiasm to explore more and to experience more and to open up yourself to a quite abstract and large world of art. But don't forget to read the primary source, read your books, go to the concerts, go to the operas, do just the things that you don't know
and have never experienced, and then get touched by the power of music and the power of arts, because that power is so enormous, sometimes so overwhelming even, that it will grab you in an instant. So I'm quite optimistic actually about that.
Okay, good. So, Drusen, thank you, Felix.